जी।
श्योर श्योर मैम।
ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच एवरीवन अन फॉर लिसनिंग पेशेंटली फॉर मी। प्लीज ब्लेस मी सो आई कैन रीड प्रॉपरली। सो आई विल पे ओबेसेंसेस टू ऑल द वैष्णवास वंश कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यः च पितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। आनंद कोटि वैष्णववृंद की जय। श्री धाम वृंदावन की जय। सो वी विल स्टार्ट टुडे। टुडे इज द 8th डे ऑफ परिक्रमा एंड 8th डे इज द बहुलाष्टमी। सो बहुला अष्टमी इज द अपीयरेंस डे ऑफ राधा कुंड एंड so I will start we will start the parikrama from Radha Kunda today. Yatha Radha Priya Vishnu Tasya Kundam Priyam Tatha Sarva Gopishu Seveka Vishnur Tyakno Vallabha. Just as Srimati Radharani is most dear to Lord Krishna, so her lake known as Radha Kunda is also very dear to him. Of all the gopis, Srimati Radharani is certainly the most beloved. Longing to meet but forced to remain separate, Radha and Krishna assume the forms of Radha Kunda and Shyam Kunda. In this way, they became splashed with the nectar of meeting each other. Radha and Krishna are one soul in two forms. And that Kunda is as dear as dear to Krishna as Radharani. Those who have transcendental eyes can see Radha Kunda as the scriptures describe it, with jewel steps leading down to the water, overhung with fruit. So their jewel step leading down to the water, overhung with fruit laden trees and air fragrant with flowers and edged by gardens. In his Govinda Lilamrita, Krishnadat Kaviraj Goswami revealed that Radha Kunda is surrounded in the eight direction by the eight kunjas of Srimati Radharani's principal sakhis. The natural beauty of these kunjas lies beyond any mundane experience of beauty we may have had in this world. Likewise, Shyama Kunda is surrounded by the kunjas of Krishna's eight principal friends or his priya sakhas, each of who's submitted for his kunja to different gopis to manage. The Radha Kunda and its surrounding area is sense of many wonderful pastimes of divine couple in the Madhyanna portion of their eternal eightfold daily pastime. This period lasts from 10:48 a.m. to 3:36 p.m. and the pastimes include quarreling over picking flowers, stealing Krishna's food, water sports, swing festival and playing dice. Next come Kundeshwar Mahadev. As we enter the Kunda area from the southern side, we pass Radha Gokulananda temple. we began our parikrama by offering our obeisances to Kundeshwar Mahadev, one of the four Shiva deities who protect Radha Kunda from coming of unqualified persons. Radha Krishna temple, Radha Kunda is Kunda's bank are decorated with many temples just down the road, and then down a small alley to the left stands Radha Krishna temple. How to the presiding home to presiding deities of deities of Radha Kunda. These deities are discovered by Srila Raghunath Das Goswami while he was overseeing the excavation of Radha Kunda. Gopal Manipur Mandir. We then proceed to Gopal Manipur temple not far from junction between Radha Kunda and Govardhan Parikrama. Turning right and continue down the road, we arrive at Gopinath temple and Samadhi of Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. When Raghunath Das Goswami entered the Lord's eternal pastimes, his mortal remain were placed in Samadhi at Shyamakunda. There is always kirtan going on and day and night. The sweet sound of the holy names saturates the already spiritually resplendent atmosphere. Raghunath Das Goswami is an intimate associate of Lord Chaitanya in Gauralila, and Radha Krishna's pastime he is Rati Manjiri, a dear assistant of Srimati Radharani. Having renounced household life while still in young age, he spent 16 years intimately serving Lord Chaitanya in Jagannath Puri. When Mahaprabhu completed his manifest pastime in this world, Raghunath Das afflicted in intense separation, came to Vrindavan and decided to end his life by jumping from the top of Govardhan Hill. Rupa Goswami and Sanatan Goswami stopped him doing so. He came to life as a simple mendicant on the bank of Shyamakunda. While living here, he would speak for 3 hours daily about Lord Chaitanya's pastimes. Raghunath Das Goswami monumental devotional effort are renowned through the Vaishnava world, and it's only by his pure desire that we now visit Radha Kunda. His wish to enlarge the Kundas was so strong that the Lord Krishna personally appeared in the dream of a rich man in Badrikashram and directed him to donate money to Raghunath Das Goswami. On hearing this pilgrim's account, the Goswami was filled with happiness. With great joy, he used the money to spend to build the two kundas. Raghunath Das Goswami spent 40 years performing bhajan here. He remained absorbed in filling of separation. It's said that his observance of devotional principle was as rigid as lines in stone. Sri Raghunath Das Goswami daily bhajan included chanting 64 rounds of japa, 100,000 holy names, doing a manasi seva in his spiritual body, worshipping Govardhan Shila, bathing thrice in Radha Kunda, offering 1,000 obeisances to Krishna and offering 2,000 obeisances to Vaishnava, and then embracing them. He rested only 90 minutes a day, and sometimes he will not even do that. Keep in mind, however, that when a eternal associate of Lord appears to race eternally, he continued his service. He ate only one leaf cup of buttermilk every day. Raghunath Das Goswami's mercy flow abundantly in this place. He is our Prayojana Guru. We can't think about Radha Kunda without remembering Raghunath Das Goswami. Next is Janama Mata Baitak. We exit the temple through the door to our left and come out on northern bank of Radha Kunda to a small platform, which is the sitting place of Janava Mata. Following the departure of Lord Chaitanya and his close associates, so Janava Mata, Lord Nityananda's eternal consort, became a powerful preacher. Although she was a woman, she was as respected as any other senior Vaishnava Acharya in our line, and she organized devotional activities of many Vaishnavas. Her visit to Radha Kunda is described in Bhakti Ratnakar. It is at her baithak beneath Tamala tree that Janava Mata was blessed with the transcendental vision of Gopinath, accompanied by Radharani and the gopis. The Radha Kunda, Radha Gopinath deities were installed after this incident. The Gaurangopika reveals that in Krishna Lila, Janava Mata is Ananga Manjiri, Srimati Radharani's younger sister. There is a description of Radha Kunda that tells us that there is an island in the middle of Kunda. Placed over the waters in middle of Radha Kunda is a wonderful jewel palace where Ananga Manjiri with great love serves the divine couple. Without love and devotion, no one is able to know about this place. A few steps lead to into Janava Mata's private bathing place in Radha Kunda, built for her by her followers. We go back to back along the steps of Radha Kunda towards Raghunath Das Goswami Samadhi, and when we reach the corner of Kunda, we return right and walk towards Sangam of Kunda and Radha Kunda and Shyam Kunda. When we come to very narrow passage on our left, barely wide enough to walk one person, so we enter on that place. To our left stand the Bhajan Kutir of Srila Gopal Bhatt Goswami. As a child, Gopal Bhatt had the wonderful opportunity to serve Lord Chaitanya directly when the Lord was in his home in Sri Rangam for the 4 months of Chaturmasa. The Lord blessed the child to go to Vrindavan after his parents' physical departure. After studying under Srila Prabodhananda Saraswati Thakur, he eventually came to Vrindavan and was welcomed with great love and by Rupa and Sanatan Goswami. A few more steps bring us to three Goswami Swamadhi, the most secret resting place of Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, Srila Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami and Raghunath Bhatt Goswami. These three Goswamis passed away on the same day in different years. We circumambulated Samadhi, reverential, and offering our obeisances, praying sincerely to follow in the footsteps of these Acharya and to become absorbed in their writings. We walked to Shyamakunda and stopped for some time at Manasa Pavana Ghat. On the northern bank of Shubala Kunda, named Shubala Kunda, Shubalananda. This Kunja is was accepted by Radha and is known as Manasa Pavan Ghat. Sri Radha always eagerly bathed there with her girlfriends. For this water consistence of honey flowing from Krishna's lotus feet. Therefore, this water is as dear to her as Krishna himself. The five Pandavas absorbed in the beauty of Radha Kunda and Shyama Kunda. Shyama Kunda has an irregular shape because when it was being due, Raghunath Das Goswami dreamed of Maharaj Yudhishthira, who revealed that he and his brothers were living there as fire trees. He asked Raghunath Das Goswami not to cut them down. These fire trees are no longer there now. Along where we stand is a bhajan kutir of Raghunath Das Goswami. As we rise from offering our obeisances, we see the colorful mural which carefully captured every daily of detail of the devotion. The Raghunath Das Goswami was satisfied simply with chanting and meditating on the bank of the Kunda. One day when Goswami was deeply absorbed in trance, tiger and tigress came to water to quench their thirst. Raghunath Das Goswami was unaware of what was happening around him. So absorbed in samadhi he was. So just to protect his devotees, Krishna personally appeared and kept an eye on the animals while they was drinking water. Sanatan Goswami arrived at that time moment and witnessed the scene. Krishna smiled at him, and when the tiger left, the Lord disappeared too. Sanatan then tried to convince Raghunath Das to build himself a shelter so the Lord wouldn't have to worry about him. On other occasion, while Raghunath Das Goswami sat in deep meditation under the midday sun, Srimati Radharani appeared behind him to shade him for the scorching sun and with her own cloth. She herself was drenched in perspiration. Again, Sanatan Goswami witnessed the scene. After some time, Srimati Radharani smiled at Sanatan and left. This time, Sanatan Goswami Goswami admonished his exalted friend for inconveniencing Lord's concert and again demanded he build a kutir. Raghunath Das Goswami agreed, and from then onwards he performed his bhajan in this place. on the left of the kutir, Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur will do bhajan here approximately century and a half after Raghunath Das Goswami. As we head in direction of Parikrama path around Kunda and Radha Kunda and Shyama Kunda, we stop at the Gauragadada temple and at Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami's Bhajan Kutir, which is right next to it. Lord Nityananda instructed Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in a dream to leave his home in Bengal and go to Vrindavan. Although he was already quite old, he followed the Lord's instruction and lived next to Raghunath Das Goswami on the bank of Radhakunda, taking full shelter of him. So there is a Bhajan Kutir of Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami right next to Raghunath Das Goswami's Kutir. Inspired by the talks and diary of Raghunath Das Goswami, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami spent his final days here writing the Chaitanya Charitamrita, this most special gem among Vaishnava literature. He also compiled the Govinda Leelamrita in this place. When Srila Raghav Pandit, Narottam Das Thakur and Srinivas Acharya came here during their parikrama of Praja, they met with Raghunath Das Goswami and Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. We go around the corner and squeeze our way into the entrance of temple with where Giriraja's tongue is worshipped. Raghunath Das Goswami didn't want people to use the secret Radha Kunda water for their daily requirements. So he decided to have a separate well dug to provide for them. While digging, the worker struck a stone that began to bleed. Raghunath Das Goswami immediately stopped digging. And that night, Giriraj appeared to him in a dream and informed him that the stone was his tongue and that it should be installed in a temple and worshipped. We offer prayers to this Govardhan Shila, which is still marked with specks of blood. Next, we go to temple of Sri Radha Govinda Dev. Just like the deities in Vrindavan, their worshippers are Srila Rupa Goswami's Pratibha deities. In the late 17th century, when Aurangzeb ordered that all Goswami temples be dismantled, the devotees in Vraja tried to save the various deities by moving them to Jaipur. On their way to Jaipur, the three principal deities of Gaudiya Vaishnava stopped at Radha Kunda and Kamyavan. Pratibha deity is considered as good as the original ones. Were installed in their original temple in Vrindavan, as we see in Radha Kunda and Kamyavan. The other two deities named Sri Radha Madan Mohan and Sri Radha Gopinath also have their Pratibha form at Radha Kunda. Sri Radha Madan Mohan are on the southern bank of Shyam Kunda, a few meters away from Sangam of Sri and Sri Radha Gopinath are further down the same path close to Nityananda Baithak. A road to the left leads of the Parikrama path to Bhakti Vinod Thakur's Bhajan Kutir. We stop there to relish meditative thoughts and melodious kirtan. Bhakti Vinod Thakur predicted that one day all the people of world would come, would chant Lord Chaitanya's glory. It was his foremost desire to see the best embrace Krishna consciousness. Srila Prabhupada has since brought an array of colorful elements to chant. Jai Sachinandana Gaurahari. Radha Kunda is one sense in cradle of ISKCON because it is on the bank of Radha Kunda. Next comes the Jagannath temple. We return to Parikrama route and a little way around the path on our left, we take darshan of Lord Jagannath, Lady Subhadra and Lord Balaram. Every year during Ratha Yatra, their worship Lord Shiva are paraded around the Parikrama Marg on handful cart. A short distance ahead and our right is the entrance of Srila Jiva Goswami's Bhajan Kutir. Jiva Goswami, son of Rupa Goswami's younger brother Anu, was the youngest of six Goswamis. He spent much time assisting Raghunath Das Goswami in the excavation and management of Kundas. After the departure of Rupa and Sanatan Goswami, he became the Acharya of the Vaishnavas. Inside the Kutir, we find the cast of Lord Chaitanya's large footprints which were brought here from Jagannath Puri. There is also a small Radha Damodar temple here. Directly across the road from Jiva Goswami's Bhajan Kruti is Lalita Kunda and the Lalita Mohan temple. The Raja Bhakti Vilas mentioned that Lalita Devi used water from Radha Kunda and Shyam Kunda to make her own Kunda. The Parikrama path then takes us to eastern tip of Shyam Kunda where the tongue of Govardhan was found. This place is called Gopi Kunda. Kupa means well. Gopi Kupa. Kupa means well. On the other side of the road and down a narrow path is the place where Srila Madhavendra Puri sat while doing Govardhan Parikrama. A small monument marks this exalted personality sitting place. Madhavendra Puri took sannyas from the Dhamma Madhva Sampradaya. He set the ends and mood for the advent of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who took initiation from Madhavendra Puri's disciple Srila Ishwara Puri. We return to the Parikrama path and walk to some time before coming to Tamala Tala. The Tamala tree on the bank of Shyamakunda, under which Lord Chaitanya sat after discovering Radha Kunda and Shyamakunda. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur installed a set of marble footprints of Lord Chaitanya here. Until Lord Chaitanya visited Vrindavan, these most secret lakes remained concealed. They seem to be only two ponds in middle of two different paddy fields. At that time, the village of Radha Kunda was born as Arishtagram or Arishtagram, because this was where Krishna had killed Arishtasura. When the Lord arrived here and inquired about the whereabouts of Radha Kunda, no one could direct him. We go past the Madan Mohan temple, which houses the Pratibha deities of Sanatan Goswami's beloved Radha Madan Mohan. Walk about 30 meters to Radha Gopina temple. There we take darshan of Sri Madhupandit's deities as mentioned about their lordship or Pratibha deities. In this compound, we also visit Lord Nityananda's sitting place. Like Lord Balaram, he toured all the holy Tirtha of India and finally arrived in Vrindavan. It was at this point that he understood Lord Chaitanya had begun the Sankirtan movement and he went straight to Nadi. The rest of our day is spent and resting. A few of devotees decided to go to festival of Bahulashtami. So we will end our 8th day here. The delightful forest of Vrindavan, beautiful Govardhan Hill and the nectarine area of the Rasadas, what to speak of other places are not equal to even a single particle of Radha Kunda and Shyam Kunda. Let me take shelter of these two lakes which are more dear to Lord Krishna than his own life's breath. So we will end the day of 8th day and next we go to Radha, from Radha Kunda to Tik. Each of us leave Radha Kunda, we have fairly good indication to whether we have managed to adapt to the Parikrama lifestyle. So while walking, first come is the Chakratirtha and Chakreshwar Mahadev. Where at entrance we turn right and walk a short distance before turning left towards the area known as Chakratirtha. Chakratirtha is one of the north bank of Manasi Ganga. When Krishna lifted Govardhan Hill, his Sudarshan Chakra hung above Giriraj, evaporating the torrent rains by spinning and generating tremendous heat. Sudarshan served his Lord like this for the entire 7 days of the pastime. After Krishna replaced Govardhan Hill, Sudarshan begged the Lord's permission to remain in this place. Here we find the temple of Chakreshwar Mahadev, who is one of the four Kshetrapalas of Brajamandal. Next to Chakreshwar Mahadev temple is the Bhajan Kutir of Srila Sanatan Goswami. From his residence here, the elderly saint would daily perform the 24-mile Govardhan Parikrama. While he walked, he repeatedly offered obeisances to Govardhan as well as to any devotee he met along the way. One day when Sanatan Goswami was already quite old, the Lord appeared before him in a guise of cowherd boy, and a sweet exchange took place. Sanatan Goswami, with tears in his eyes, tried to conceal his fatigue condition from the boy. Gopinath spoke sweetly to Sanatan. In this old age, you should not take so much trouble. Dear Swamiji, please follow my advice. Sanatan Goswami replied, whatever you say, I will certainly follow. Then the cowherd boy climbed Govardhan Hill and brought a shila marked with his own footprint. In sweet words, he requested Sanatan Goswami to accept this Govardhan Shila marked with footprint of Lord Krishna. From today, just circumambulate this Shila and your vow of daily parikrama will be fulfilled. Saying this, he gave the Shila to Sanatan Goswami at this cottage and disappeared. This Shila is still worshipped at Radha Damodar temple in Vrindavan. On another occasion, Sanatan Goswami, after some contemplation, decided to leave his bhajan kutir because there were too many mosquitoes. And at that moment, Chakreshwar Mahadev appeared in his guise of Brahmana and begged him not to go. He promised to clear area mosquitoes from there. So local residents claim that to this day the area is relatively mosquito free. Leaving Chakratirtha, we follow the back to the street of Parikrama Mark on the other side of Govardhan Hill near Sakhisthali village. As we walk, sometimes turn around to see Govardhan Hill disappearing into the distance. It's quite spectacular, even mystical sight. Govardhan spread horizontally from miles and appear to have a blushy view to the trees that grow on the his top and sides. Gopala's ancient temple at the top carries one thought to the devotional incident that thou the paths of Govardhan Hill with remembrance of Krishna. After walking to about 3 kilometers, we enter Ghantuli Gram. Ghantuli means knot. Ghanta means knot. And the Bhakti Ratnakar says that once while celebrating Holi here, the Sakhis secretly tied Krishna's cloth to Radharani's cloth, and as they sat on their simhasan, at one point the divine couple stood up and realized their cloth had been tied just like a married couple. They became embraced and all the Sakhis laughed and clapped in great fun. After they had thrown colors at each other, their cloth was untied again. Gulalakunda, which is located just before the entrance of Ghantuli Gram, was given this name because its waters turned pink from the colors being thrown around during Holi. The pink powder is called lard. So so much powder was thrown into the air that it appeared like a pink cloud. As it settled in coached everything, the trees were pink, the birds pink, and the water of Kunda and people's faces and clothes all became pink. So Gulal Kunda has borne this name since Krishna was there performing his pastime, and in the spring holy festival is still held there. Kantulikam Gram is famous for another beautiful pastime. During the night, Lord Chaitanya stayed at the Haridev temple. He wondered how to see the Gopal deity who lived on top of Govardhan Hill. Being in the mood of devotee, Mahaprabhu refused to climb Govardhan Hill, which is not different from Krishna. Gopala, however, understood Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's heart and played a trick so he could grant his darshan to the Lord. By his arrangement, a rumor spread that the Turkish soldiers were preparing to attack the village where he was living. When the villagers heard this, they moved Gopala to Kantuli Gram, and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was able to see him. The news eventually reached to Lord Chaitanya that Gopala had moved, so he came here to take darshan of deities. Beholding the beautiful form of Gopala, Mahaprabhu became completely overwhelmed by ecstatic love and recited the following verse: Vamastam Rasakshasya Bhuja Dandana Patuva Krida Kantu Katam Yena Nita Govardhana Giri. May the left arm of Krishna, whose eyes are like a petals of lotus flower, always protect you. With his left arm and rise Govardhan Hill as if it were a toy. Then he began to chant and dance and did not stop until the end of the day. Who can understand the ecstasy of emotion of flooded his heart when the dance when he danced in Gopala's pleasure. The Lord took darshan of the deity here for 3 days. On the fourth day, Gopala returned to his temple on a top of Govardhan Hill. This was the only time Gopala left the hilltop temple to give his darshan to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The Chaitanya Charitamrita says from time to time he would use the same pretext to remote attack by the Muslims. Due to fear of Muslims, the Gopala deity was moved from one place to another place again and again. Thus giving up his temple, Lord Gopala would sometimes live in a bush and sometimes in one village after another. Our walk to Dik long about 19 kilometers, but there are no thorns, sands or pebbles. Rather, we walk the road on the sand. One devotee thinks that the roads are not good for walking. The sand is so soft and we can walk on it. Ahead on the Govardhan to Dik road is Bahaj, formerly known as Raheja. Here a remorseful fool Indra approach Krishna accompanied by Surabhi. This is also where Rajasthan begins. Of course, we have to be careful not to think the transcendental realm Vraja belongs to some mundane state or province. Of the 10 offenses to the holy name Dham, holy Dham, that we reside daily on Parikrama is the 6th offense. It should not consider the Dham as the mundane part of mundane world. We stop in a field from as we arrived in Dik, we are welcomed by young Vaishnava who called out us, "You have arrived in Dik. Welcome to Dik. This place is a stepping stone for us to Badrinath." So next is the Dik to Badrinath. So thank you very much. We'll stop here. We have finished our 9 days parikrama so far.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you for all the effort.
Thank you, Mataji, for patiently listening, and please forgive me if I have made any mistake.
Thank you, Chavaguri. Mrs. Govardhan Dham ki jai, Jis Dham kun Varada Khand ki jai.
Ki jai. Vrindavan Dham ki jai.
Thank you so much.